to our fourth game. It is going to be a Protoss versus Zerg here at the Probe StarCraft League. Make sure you are tuning in to this particular channel when these games are on. Make sure you click that follow button, and we'll be here to deliver you some fantastic games. It is going to be on starting out on Belshire Vestige here for this matchup between Jacko and Crimson. And down in the bottom right hand side as our red Zerg player here, it is Crimson, and the top left as a green Protoss is Jacko.
Ooh, this is going to be interesting. I can't wait to see how many naturals are connected to the main via creep.
Me too. I'm expecting to see Jacko's main and Nat connected, actually. So
yeah, he's like, going to have a full Psy range connection, like the pylons, just to rub it in.
Yeah.
He's going to connect his main and Nat to Crimson's main and Nat.
Oh.
That's what I want to see.
Oh.
The ultimate BM.
You know what, just make my day? A Night of Swarm, like, at the natural, the main ramp. So that it does touch both of the bases, the creep.
Amazing.
That would be glorious.
I am a big fan of Nidus Worms.
Yeah.
This is so
annoying.
Pretty
cool.
Oh man, bro.
This is like that
17-17.
Yeah, this is like that in the Zerg versus Zerg where that big Baneling hit and you're like, oh. This is exactly
like in the last game of Demilove.
Yeah.
The big Baneling.
Where you just like, I didn't want to have to deal with that.
Oh, he's
block,
still there.
Continuing
God,
to get the
go
block
away,
nicely
bro.
Down by Jacko. Oh. Yeah. That's
it's annoying to watch, but it is actually pretty hard to pull this off as to maintain the health on the probe.
Oh yeah.
He's finally gonna get pushed back now, but God, that's annoying. Like, look at that. He had 500 minerals in the bank before he could even drop his natural, and it's not like he committed anything to it at all. It was just his entire mechanical micro skill that allowed him to do that.
Mm-hmm. I remember people used to do this a lot more in things like in the Terran matches, like where it was TVP and Terran versus Zerg, where you would use like just any sort of like a fake building, a supply depot,
an engineering bay,
an eBay or something
like
that.
You gained so much health.
Yeah, and it was, I don't know, people just stopped doing that, I guess. So
Terran build is incredibly tight. Like, you're spending every single mineral and gas you have for like 3 minutes. You're sitting there with like 10-10 in the bank. I don't think you'd have the room to squeeze in the engineering bay.
Yeah. I think as well, given the difference in the game timing scales now compared to Heart of the Swarm and Wings of Liberty, where it was full on like, hey, it's the 6 minute mark, I'm about to take my natural. And so you could actually have that a little bit of extra expenditure there, I think, was also a big difference. Whereas now it's like, hey, it's the 6 minute mark, I'm gonna take my fourth base. And so it is different in that particular aspect of it as well.
Also, back then, if you ever played Protoss versus Terran in Heart of the Swarm, you knew how bad it was. When you scout your natural, there's no SEV. You're like, ah, nice. And you cancel the Zealot that you were making.
Yep.
And then there's an engineering bay when you go look again, and you're like, but I canceled the Zealot. This game's over.
Yeah.
Like, I lost.
Yeah. And it's also like why we started seeing some particular builds that were like Nexus, Gate Nexus, then Cyber. That started to really pop up quite a lot more at the sort of that mid to later part of Heart of the Swarm. Whereas
there
course,
was a time when people thought you were crazy for doing that because it's like, there's no way you'd
live. Yeah,
and
you just
showed you like,
that. It's like, wow.
No, you live.
Yeah. It's interesting how the things change over time.
Yeah,
but
developed. Yeah, as we've gotten mechanically better and completely standard game here, by the way, to both players.
Yeah,
I want to see a Evo Chamber come out of Crimson soon, get some Baneling Nest first, and then get melee. He's putting a lot of gas. Kind of interesting.
Yep.
But all's normal.
Yeah,
probably gonna
see
the Protoss push out
once
Glaives finishes.
We got a couple of extra buildings here at the front. We got that extra pylon just in case the defensive cannons were needed. Yeah, really cool stuff. And of course he's now up to a total of 3 gates right now, I believe it is. Yeah. And the Robo on the way. So we'll see those flower open in a second, and then we'll probably have the War Prison coming out as it's quite reasonable timing. I mean,
Is Crimson going for a bust? He's kind of making a lot of lings, and he's pulling a lot of gas. I see him getting melee, but unless he just knows this is the Glaive's timing and he's just making a lot of stuff, I'd be ready for it.
Yeah. Not sure. I don't think it's a bust. Just based on getting that melee. You'd either, if you were getting melee, you'd want it to be useful, not sort of if you're busting and it's like, hey, in a couple of minutes I'll have the melee upgrade. So
also huge development between the natural main of Crimson. It's connected, actually.
Oh, I don't know. No, there's
you don't. That's not connected enough for you.
No,
that's connected enough for me. There's like little downtime. I like it. Oh, shades in the natural. They're gonna get eaten by these veilings. Oh, look at that thing. But
reasonable attempt to split there by Jacko. He does. He doesn't really get too much done. I was really interested. I was gonna say because the timing of the warp prism was just a touch later than normally what you would see, because you would either have extra. You would have those adepts trying to push in and just distract them by a bit of time for the prism to come down, but he sort of just went straight in, so it was...
Yeah, he went right into the natural. Yeah. But, I mean, he got a lot of scouting information, he forced a lot of units. This is kind of like that we're going to knife fight each other part of the game for the Protoss and Zerg. While they do want a macro, they do have to stay alive.
Yep.
So, looks like we are going to be seeing some Baneling drops? Is that what we're... No, they're just here to defend. Yep. I saw him getting pneumatic carapace.
Nice little bit of micro inside the main. He's using the low ground now as well. That is really, so really cool usage. Yeah, we'd love to see him sort of come back in and drop a few more shots on that queen, but he is going to back out for now. Jacko attempting to hold that third base. He will do so. And lots and lots of sentries now coming up for our Protoss player. We can see the Crimson is now grabbing his fourth across on the left-hand side. Meanwhile, the Prism still just lurking about, looking to drop down these adepts. You can't really walk any extras in, so I think this is just
but three adepts do so much damage on their own.
Yep.
And the pickup range, it's really non-committal.
Yep.
Free, just totally free. Free. You've got the micro for it.
Yeah. So Jack is going to add in a bunch of gates down at the third. I like that that defense there. It's pretty good and really difficult to bust in. He's got the fancy immortal skin, I'll also just point out as well. Looks.
I don't like that immortal skin, but I don't like any skins. They look like AA guns and they can't even shoot up. What's the point?
Yeah. Looks like one of those... looks like it's meant to Crimson. Go fast.
Crimson supply blocked pretty hard here, and his Hydra Den just finished. You think he'd want to make like a swell of Hydras or drones or something, but there we go.
There we go.
Swell of Hydras.
Ten on the way. Money. Yeah. So we will see the Bane and... Hydra based composition here to deal with the adepts.
Pretty standard.
There's adepts and there are the sentries, which is going to be really interesting, given that how much damage they can do in terms of cutting up the map. So Jacko's now going to move out. I think he knows that the fourth base is there, or at least he's going to have a little look.
He has a good guess. Yeah, he's got a good guess.
He's going to get in here. There's no real way I think that Crimson can defend this because of the sentries should be able to block everything out. There you go. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Keep the warp prism alive, and it looks like the Hydras have got a really nice surface area here.
Sentries are in front.
Couple more. Yeah, not too sure about
that.
Ooh, that hurts.
That was a big hit.
That hurts. Lots of adepts now, though. But we've still got a lot of units down the back. Drones are even coming in. They're going to come across and try and transfer. It looks like the warp prism will go down. Very nice defense. Loses the hatch, but does destroy this army. Yeah, he should be able to just polish all of this off. A couple more attempts to save the day from the sentry. Looks as if these units are going to back out now. And
depending on the rally, Crimson might be able to end the game off of this.
Yeah.
It's going to depend on the micro, both players.
I was going to say, I really like the micro there, just to run around the back and try and stop the units from getting back. And that's a decent account of Hydras there as well. And we're going to have a lot of Banes coming up. Looks as if Crimson is going to try and...
Good positioning by Jacko. Him not yielding this high ground is really important to keep the Banelings off of his buildings.
Yep.
Every second matters.
I'm not a fan of the positioning from coming down the ramp. I would have loved to see him just sort of utilize the top, but he does do quite
well. When you can
build
walls, it doesn't really matter.
That's true.
Map editors are some of the strongest members of the StarCraft community.
That's true. We always love our map editors. And looks as if Crimson's going to have to retreat here. He lets it go. Does let it go. The Banelings drop in and they will take out a number of those adepts. Loses the Zelnaga Watchtower and Crimson's forced to back out. This is going to be like tip for tat kind of stuff. It looks as if...
the game's like teeter-tottering. One guy punches the other and it's like they both just want a macro. But I feel like this is going to favor the Zerg. His units have that explosive potential to just take a really good fight, whereas Jacko has to play perfect every single fight.
Yeah. And nice upgrades for those Banes, by the way. There's +2 to melee, so they do quite a lot of damage. Not sure about moving into that position there. Crimson's going to have to back out for now.
He's going to wiggle his way out, and he'll be all right. He's just making so many units. Like, as these units pop, he's going to have a giant army.
Yeah.
I don't think the Protoss wins this.
No, I don't. I'm not sure.
No, I don't think. I saw the shade on top. I'm like, this isn't how this works.
Get the prism. Get the
focus
prism.
Focus the prism. Yeah! Massive. That was awesome. Look at that.
Really nice work there from Crimson. He's got his fourth base up. Huge. He is mining from this fourth base as well. Let's keep that in mind. So he's doing really well on the economic front. He's up to 129 supply versus the 87 of our Protoss player here. And Jacko's just trying to wildly build some units so that he can try and defend this bush, because it is coming and it is heavy. 68 Zerg army supply to the 45 of the Protoss. Lots of adepts over here at the third base. They will be forced to sort of back up into the defensive position there. Nice force field. Yeah, looks as if the front door of the Nat is open for business though, as the Banelings roll through. Plus two to their melee attack is doing wonderful work there. Hydras, I'm not too sure about pushing into that, but I mean, there is just too much Zerg. Is just too much Zerg. Probably should get
and
that.
And these trades favor him greatly because he has a force base mining. Even if he were to lose his army, it'd be a gigantic trade in favor of him. Yeah, he taps out.
And there you go. So game number one of Crimson versus Jacko goes the way of Crimson. We'll be jumping into game two very quickly here. And
we all know why he won that game, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Because he connected his main and his nat.
That's right.
That reinforced time helps out with Hydras.
It just means those extra seconds there that those units can get to the front. Yeah.
That sentry energy was not able to accumulate.
That's exactly right.
It all matters.
Not only that, but shield energy from some of the units wasn't able to get back up if they were damaged or something like that.
That's true,
because
the Banelings. Banelings are functionally EMPs. When like one hits, it's like, oh man.
They're like life EMPs. Ooh, but not talk about life when we're talking about StarCraft. Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I think the stream just got banned because you said that. I'm sorry, Probe.
So we are on New Coke Precinct. Down on the bottom right-hand side, our green Protoss player. It is Jacko. He's going to be going out for what looks to be, I'm going to assume this is going to be just standard gateway stuff.
Going to be a gate, yep.
Yep.
Mm. Like to see a cannon rush once in my life.
Me too, I was going to say. And down on the bottom left-hand side, Crimson with his Zerg. Going to be grabbing that hatchery pretty soon. There's
Man, look at that building placement. He's got such forward thinking. He knows exactly how his wall is going to shape up by the time it's done.
Yep.
I can't be like that.
No,
I don't. It's just random.
Yeah.
Wherever the buildings fall, they fall.
Yeah. Crimson taking the natural here, just continuing to drone up. It looks as if he is going to...
Ooh, three hatch before pool.
Yeah.
Greedy. I like it.
Interesting. Is the probe going to see it?
Jacko showed... He was... Oh. Get him. Get him, probe.
I think he went to like, you know, be deceptive and go up there, but it was kind of like, we're just going to walk past each other anyway. Oh, no, it was just checking for cheese. Okay, fair enough.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. So he's going to... play it out standard. I like that.
Maybe he'll take this as his third. Oh, okay.
Maybe he'll take the gold base. Wait.
Maybe he'll kill the rocks with the drone and then take the base down to the bottom.
I like to see that. You just make a bunch of banelings and you attack the rocks. How many banelings would it take to kill these rocks? Like, it's got to be worth it in the long run, right?
That's going to be in one of those like useless facts with Fear Dragon or something like that.
Yeah. How many banelings does it take to take out the debris on Newkirk Precinct?
Yeah.
I'd like to see that one.
Yeah.
Maybe we could do that one, you know? Like, we could help out the community.
Yeah. It's important information.
It is.
Just like connecting your main and your
I feel like my gameplay would be better. That's true. Very true.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those seconds. They mean everything.
And then
StarCraft is a game of inches, and a lot of people play it in yards, which is a problem.
And then you make it even more inefficient, and you go to like a map like Metalopolis. No, Metropolis, where it's got the islands with the rocks on it. You remember that one? And it's like, how many... what do you need to ferry the Banelings across to the island and destroy the rocks with the Banelings? But he's going to head up here and take his third base.
Ah,
he's,
Stargate here from Jacko. I like this.
Yep.
Stargate, I really like Stargate openers. The Oracle is just, like, the best early game spellcaster in the game, hands down. Like, the Raven's good, but the Oracle, between the Stasis Trap, the Revelation, and the, you know, just basic attack is just incredibly strong.
And it looks as if Jacko's going to have a quick look in the natural here. Going to back out for now. Let's see if he can get anything
done. Back. Maybe Queens are the best early game spellcaster. I'm thinking
Queen's
about this now.
Good,
Queens
yeah.
are really good. Yeah, Queens are really good. I mean, they can connect your Nat and your main with creep. And no other unit could do that.
No, that's true. Like, the only real thing that could is another hatchery. And I mean...
That's true.
Yeah.
Hatchery's the second best spellcaster, then.
That's true. Second best spellcaster unit in the game.
I like Crimson doing his due diligence here. He's not skipping Pneumatic Carapace, even though he's kind of seen what Jacko has to offer. He's going to get in and see this Oracle, and it's a pretty big shift his opponent's putting on, and he's going to be prepared for it.
Yep.
I skip the Pneumatic Carapace all the time. I'm like, ah, whatever. The guy's probably bad. He's not doing anything other than glaives. Whatever.
I was just thinking that.
When your Melbourne land points are on the
that's true.
Line.
That's true. You got to be careful with those land points. So, I think, as you said, it's pretty common to see like a standard sort of range. It's either like going to be Oracle or Adepts or maybe both, of course. And
or Blink
sort of...
DTs.
That's yeah. true. They're quite a common one as well. Yep. You got to be prepared for them. And I mean, what counters all of these things? Are spores and queens. So just, you know, make some of those things.
Staple
and...
early game units for drones. That is really the Zerg race to me. It's
it
just
is.
The drone
it
race.
Is. Just make drones.
Just make drones. Where's Rhett? Rhett would tell us
true.
It's just the drone race.
Yeah. Rhett would just be like, yeah, just make drones. So we are.
I like to see the Oracles knowing that they can't get any damage get active with stasis traps. There's a. Stats showed us in the GSL finals
Ooh.
That. You can still do a Oof. Lot of damage with stasis traps.
Yeah, it was amazing. I loved watching that. Like, I'd always looked
Incredible.
At it. I was kind of figuring, why are these oracles sitting here useless until about mid-game when you just start tagging stuff? And then
yeah,
it's like...
And that's really it.
Yeah, and it's just kind of, well, I'll put a stasis down. And when you think about it, the stasis doesn't cost anything. As long as you're
no,
putting it down in a safe position. Yeah, because it's just like... For me, as someone who plays a lot of late game kind of matches, like I try and get to late game, one of the biggest things is that you look for is you try and get a lot of these the energy based units, because of course at the end of the game
yeah.
when the gas is gone, the minerals are gone, the only thing that
the
you can constantly
remains.
Yeah is you can just constantly reuse energy, because it actually regrows. It's effectively renewable energy, and I know that's something we don't really talk about much here in Australia, but still. So the Oracle's coming across, getting a couple of kills inside the main base, just two for the moment. And,
Adepts got picked off, trying
yeah.
to poke into the third.
Yeah.
And the Void Wraith cleaning up Overlord, so pretty much standard business.
Yeah.
This is going to be interesting how he holds this little Ling attack. He doesn't really have a big standing ground army.
No.
It's going to come down to the force field, really.
There's like one built pylon here at the third. I'm not sure why.
But it's built well. Oh, the queen dropped. That's sick. And the pylon's gonna go down! If he gets this other one, there's really no DPS here.
Gets it mainly onto the other pylon. Looks if there will be... That's a weird sentry trap there, but he does get some good damage done. Looks if the queens are gonna be picked up for now. Lots of bailings gonna be taken out by oracles of all things. Not the most common...
They all lived!
Transfuse
what?
Them! Transfuse the bailings!
No, don't transfuse a baneling. That's sacrilege. Never transfuse a baneling.
Oh god, nice. See? See, they'd still be alive! Queen's coming out here. Queen's are going to try and attack that Void Ray. They do excellent damage. Yeah, really nicely done.
Oh, the Banelings! Oh, big hit!
And
nice drop,
Crimson's
micro.
Just, yeah, that was really cool. Crimson's just
wow, he's playing
take
so
this.
Well. And that's it. There's nothing left
yeah,
to the Protoss.
You cannot do
he's
anything here.
Pieces.
He can't even hold this ramp because you can just, like, run up, firstly, and then secondly. Oh, he does have a
second.
Yeah.
Second up, the queens are just gonna come up there.
Yeah, yeah.
Does he even have a lair? No, not yet. I was gonna say, he could be dropping poop, but...
I wouldn't even
these
use...
queens don't care.
I probably wouldn't have brought the queens up, but... I mean, they're ranged.
Yeah,
but,
they're so tanky
still,
with confused. Yeah.
Still. Yeah.
They help push them back off the
ramp
so the lanes
true.
Can get up.
That's
what
true.
A cool build by Crimson. Wow. That's one of those it's not gonna work twice in a row, but wow, when it works, it's really cool. And Jacko's just trying to compose himself. He's like, what is this? Like... Anything this concise, I doubt many people have played against more than a handful of times.
And there you go, game number two going the way of Crimson. That is a pretty quick
Beautiful.
Couple of games so far. It's is that that's 2-0, I believe.
2-0.
At this point. Yeah.
2-0
so
Crimson.
It is a best of five, so we still got a little bit to go. There is of course a chance that Jacko could bring it back. He's definitely
a reverse all
capable.
Kill.
Yeah, he's definitely a capable Protoss, and we'll see what he can bring out. As we move to our next map, which is going to be Cactus Valley LE Void. And this is another map that's been around for quite a while. Not necessarily Daybreak Lake, but still pretty decent.
No.
But yeah, we
this map, you kind of forget about it. It's been in the pool a long time, but it's just kind of always there. It's like It's like some sort of disease you can't get rid of. It's just always around you.
Look, I told you not to tell anyone about that.
Look, just take medicine. You'll be fine.
Bottom
goes away.
Bottom right outside is our green Protoss, Jacko. He's down 0-2 versus the red Zerg in the top right hand side. It is Crimson. So we'll see what happens here in game number two. It looks as if it is going to be a quick scout out from Jacko. He's sending that first probe. Wants to know what's going on. Is it a cheese? Yeah. Is he going to see main connected to the NAT? All these things need to be known by the end of this game.
Not last game.
No main
connected to the NAT, and he still won.
Yeah. It was probably just luck, I guess. Oh, hang on. Where's the villa? It was probably hacks, I'd say.
Probably map hacks.
Yeah, probably. I agree.
I'd like to see Jacko in this game. I think he's playing fine in the series. I just want him to react to his reads. Like, in the last game, he sent 4 Adepts up to the top side to check the third of Crimson, and, like, 40 Zerglings swarmed him, and you've got to react to that. Like, he just kind of kept making nothing. He's just going about his macro business, and you've got to react to your reads.
Yeah.
When you're a Protoss player playing against, especially someone as aggressive as Crimson, apparently, who will just kill you.
Yeah. He'll jump right on it and take it down. Where is the Cyber? There it is. I was going to say, where are you up to, Mr. Pro? Get back here.
He's going on a stroll.
Kill that Cyber.
Rallying into gas, getting a second gas. All things normal in the Protoss space.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Did he see that Pro?
I don't think so.
What is this probe doing anyway? Is it going back now? That's kind of weird.
He's just contemplating his life decisions, where it went wrong, how he ended up working on Cactus Valley in the middle of the desert. It's hot.
I wouldn't want to work there. I don't like the hot, so.
No.
I don't like the
Crimson
hot.
Crimson doesn't actually know where Jacko is yet, because he hasn't seen any of his probes. He knows he's on the top left. Oh? Crimson?
Oh.
Is he? Oh, no, he's just looking for stuff. I thought he was pulling links. I'm like, wow, that's early.
I thought Jacko was going to do something weird at the top of the ramp because he had that, that probe sitting there. It's like
just walls him in. It's like, come on.
Those ridiculous builds which gave us the magical invention of the indestructible plate or unbuildable rocks, as they're called on this particular map.
I can't believe it's still there. You think they would have, like, changed the game instead of just leaving these rocks here for our entire lives? Hi, yeah, what keeps StarCraft balanced? Well, you see, it's these 400 health rocks.
Do you remember?
Nothing else? No, nothing else.
Do you remember when the bottom of the ramp was that sort of V shape, and so you could actually just build 2 buildings at the bottom, and then it was blocked?
I have been bunker rushed at the bottom of my ramp by Select so many times in my life. So many times. Like, it's just not even funny. He's so good at it, too.
Yeah.
I'm glad he went to go play freaking Dota. Get him out of here. He took all my WCS points before he left, but...
Well, they're not Melbourne land points, but...
They're not Melbourne, so they're not worth anything, really.
Yeah.
This Adept could get some damage by going to the NAT. It might just scout, but... No.
Says no.
Better for scouting.
Crimson now going to just have a quick pop inside the main and see what's going on here. He will find that there is an Oracle being warped in all the way from Aya.
He'll get there. Pneumatized Carapace finishing up soon, so this Overlord in no real danger.
Oh, please don't. Oh, I thought he was turning around and, like, the Oracle was going to go out a secret direction or something.
Yeah.
But no. Lots and lots of drones on the
way. You know, if he moved that Oracle around the Overlord,
he never
would have seen it.
Yeah, exactly. I thought he was going to try and do something like that, but... Eh.
That's smart moving these drones away. Oh, they're on the ramp! They can't make force! Well, I guess they'll never make force. Whoa, that was a little bit
overzealous.
He must have got a glimpse of the main of the NAT being connected by creep and got a little paralyzed.
He did. He saw it and he was kind of thinking, you know, well, that means that, you know, you can't easily attack the main or the NAT because the reinforcements will come down a lot quicker. Or come up a lot quicker, I suppose, as well.
Wherever. It's like a slip and slide. They go up and down
the
ramp quickly.
That's true. You got the slide down one end and then the ladder that goes up the other side. It's really quick. So, Jacko just doing a very similar kind of build to the previous game. In fact, I think most of his timings are actually very close to what he did last game. Building a Zealot is a little bit interesting, but there is going to be a Void
Ray. What are those units?
Yeah, exactly. There is going to be a Void Ray popping out now. And we'll probably see this Void Ray try and kill off a few Overlords here and there. The Oracles that are left over, in fact... Yeah, they've still got reasonable health, or one of them does. No, just gonna
Twilight Council or Glaives or anything on the way.
That's Jacko. That's what I was thinking. That's like the one difference.
It's a little dangerous too, because like once again we're at that point where he has no standing ground army, and I think Crimson, if he pokes out with these lings, he's making a bunch of lings. They must have all died at the watchtower. He may have been able to do a little bit of damage. But back into normal macro phases.
So the Forge and the Twilight are both on the way, along with a few more gateways in the top of Jacko's base.
I don't like that positioning at all, but that's just me. That's like, if I put those there in a game, mutas are going to roll up and just kill that pylon and be like, well,
yep.
F10N, and see you later.
And I'm off to play Hearthstone.
I'm off to play Hearthstone. Gotta play my quest, Rogue.
That's right.
Oh, that's a free queen. Wait, kill it. What? Oh, well, that confused me.
So this is cool. Look at the old production tab. Got a bit of charge going on.
It is a strong unit composition. You go like Immortal Archon charge lot, and it's really strong. You get Storm for your splash.
Yep.
Incredibly strong.
Yep. Interesting position for the Robo. I don't know about keeping it at the third. I suppose we are these positions which does allow a building like that to be at the third and it's not as threatened.
Yeah, it's actually further away from the Zerg if you think about it. I personally like building everything in the heart of my base, so like around the natural.
Yeah.
But Revelation goes down here on the natural. He's going to know where those overlords are going. Oh boy.
Yeah.
The important information.
You want to keep an eye on them. We do have Bane Speed. +2 to melee.
12 Hydras.
Yeah, and the Hydra's on the way. So very, very similar to game number one here for Crimson. He's not going to do any fancy queen dropping cool strats or anything like that. Just very traditional Hydra and Bane-based composition to deal with what in theory would be like, hey, I'm going to be building a lot of Adepts, but it is slightly different because we've got a lot of Zealots. Oh. So the
interestingly enough, Crimson's going to be getting dropped, so he can drop, like, Banelings, or is he going to just drop Lings in the main? I was going to say, dropping Banelings isn't as good when they have Zealots.
Yeah.
It's a lot better for Adepts because they're behind the Force Fields, but this is just... Oh, no! He's going to kill the Artosis Pylon with a drop.
Oh.
And the Twilight Council. Oh, no.
Oh, it's not as Artosis-y, though.
Yeah, he figured it out.
He's got the second one.
Right over here. And still, he's going to attack the third at the same time, but he sees it moving out. I like this. I like this a lot from Crimson. Under the right circumstances, a little push like this could end the game if a Protoss isn't prepared, but Jacko might just be prepared.
If that Void Ray was in a little bit of a nice position, he probably could have killed at least one of those before they got in.
Crimson!
He's going to get one of the overlords.
He faltered a little bit. No,
so the Zealots get inside, and nothing is going to happen. Meanwhile, across at the third base of our Protoss player, lots of Hydras here. They are going to be forced out to, for the time being, needs to buy that time for the storm. He's got it now. Nice little stasis trap inside the that sort of connecting position. And it looks as if a couple of greats.
What a stasis wall. I didn't even see that.
That was sort of good timing, but also bad because it messed up his storm. But the Templar will be forced to back off for now. Still has a couple more high Templar there that can drop the storms.
Everywhere.
Yeah, this is all over the place right now. We've got, it looks as if Jacko should be able to defend this. Really nice.
Yeah.
Needs to get
on
top of those
units. I don't
think he has
enough to kill
this. Yeah.
I guess
he could drop the storm.
Really good.
That's
he's going to get the fourth.
Nice,
wow,
simple
Jacko
way to clean
just
it up.
On top of it.
I was talking to Probe a little while ago about it. Zealots are actually kind of cool when you get the mix right. And of course, they throw in this factor of, they're not making Adepts. So it's kind of like, I don't remember what to do from Heart of the Swarm. So it is cool.
Yeah, you
to
forget
see
you have to get your roach count up actually to soak the Zealots. It's like a muscle we haven't flexed. Oh, this is smart though. Lurker Den. Yeah. Really good against Zealots, like really, really good.
But I mean, look at the immortal count. It's already up to 5, and there's 2 at a time popping out right now from our green Protoss player. So he's going to continue to boost up that army. Meanwhile, on the opposite side, as you said, the Hydralisk Den is switching over to become the Lurker Den. And
Crimson's going to have to be out of position this whole game just because of how low the fourth base is.
Yeah.
He's either going to have to take another fourth really quickly, or he's just going to have to protect this. Like, his life depends on it. And it kind of does. His economical life really does depend on it.
Yep. Really needs that base. And like, as we were talking about sort of the map positions as well, if he wants to take this sort of this 3 o'clock base, that's not a good idea, because he's going to be in the path of the Protoss attacking into him, plus very, very close to what is about to be the fourth base of our Protoss player. So it's like the Zealots not having the best of times over at the fourth.
He might have got it if he focused it
down. Yeah, they were on an attack move. We had a quick glimpse of that just before.
Which is interesting too, because he had vision of it, which means you can right click it
and
queue up the attack on the building from anywhere on the map.
Very true. So we're going to clear out some of the creep spread here.
Very important to do. Yeah. So he doesn't get counterattacked with this new fourth.
Yeah.
Oh, the Banelings at the third! Oh god, this is Stasis Trap! Oh! Wait, those are still Banelings. That's pretty scary. He's going to kill the pylon.
They'll kill the pylon and probably...
Oh, he's going to wall it in with Zealots?
That would... Cool. Well, he's just going to sentry. Oh! And now we've got additional Zerglings now popping in. Needs some mothership core here.
No.
I wish it was here. Needs a force field. There it is. I was going
to
say, just force field that. Just force field that, and you're good.
Ooh. Well played. And meanwhile, Protoss army. Oh, no. No, that's some lurker damage. That is some incredible lurker damage.
Ooh.
Good force field. Or good,
man, that is
the other
so
fields.
Many immortals. 9 immortals.
Yeah.
Let's just keep an eye on this this fourth base. Because it's now on 43 health, because a couple of more units got to it, but they got killed off just in time.
Like I said, he's going to have a guard his army. He's going to be really pushed out. Oh, these immortals. You know, Hydras are listed as a counter to immortals in the game, guys, so take that for what you will.
So many lurkers. And just keep in mind, guys, that these guys do bonus to armor, so they just annihilate some of these immortals when they get out of position. Hatchery did go down.
Once your shields go down.
Yeah. Fourth base went down up at the top. Interesting that this Void Ray is just chilling out watching the battle go on.
Yeah, he could snipe his Overseer, I think, in time. Yeah. He really needs to kill this Observer! Yes! Ooh. Now these Lurkers have free reign. He can just move these in, like, literally right underneath the Nexus because there's no vision.
And this also does interrupt the Immortal production, which of course leads to less Immortals to deal with the Lurkers. And Crimson slowly leapfrogging in. These Lurkers are just going to do a ridiculous amount of damage. We'd love to see some storms here, but he sort of just doesn't have those ready to go.
He doesn't
want to
commit.
To
That's the thing.
Yeah.
Oh, he gets some other support. That's a nice bonus. But meanwhile, no fourth. This is kind of all in from Crimson, but man, it's a big army.
Yeah, it's a very strong one too. While you keep those observers down, Jacko's quickly trying to rebuild one now. He's also got an oracle on the way.
Oh, it's so tense. Oh my god, it's so hard to push up this ramp. I think he needs to like get into this nook in between the natural.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of Hydras left.
That's a good storm. Nice storm. Does damage to the Lurker and the Hydras. If you can take out this Overseer, that'd be great.
Oh, he's just teasing him with it. The Sentry got it. Nice job, Sentry.
Massive damage from the Sentry at 9.
Terrible, terrible damage.
Yep. But looks like Crimson. Crimson's just going to continue to push in. The Immortals are still doing lots of damage. There you go. Revelation, down that goes. Fourth base, only just about a third of the way done for Crimson. So he's got to sort of...
Crimson's economy's in pieces.
He's got to regroup a bit. There is really not too much that he could do for the moment. He's going to try and look to take a... I imagine this drone is going to a fourth base. Oop, yes.
You got to imagine.
What the hell?
It's going to be difficult for Jacko to win this. Building the units that Hydras counter, obviously, right, Immortals?
That's right.
The game guy told me.
Especially when there's great natural to main creep spread, so the Hydras get there faster from the main.
It's
so
true.
Yeah.
That poor drone, he scouted those Zealots coming across the map and died for it.
It's like those Marines in the other game. The Marine that was like...
Yeah, but those guys lived. Those were heroes.
No. The one that got killed by the fucking massive probes.
Oh, man. That was unfortunate.
Oh, that was gold. So we do have a composition here from Jacko, of course, of the Immortal, High Templar, and Archon. Throw a couple of spicy Zealots in there from time to time. Meanwhile, from Crimson, Lurkers, Banelings, and some Hydras are what he is utilizing to try and take down his Protoss foe. Meanwhile, we still need to see Crimson boost up the economy a little bit. I don't think he can attack.
It's hard, though.
Yeah, and he's taking this base of all bases. I think that's really risky to take that base, given how close we are to the Protoss. But we'll see what he can do.
I think Jacko just steamrolls this.
Yeah.
If he just walks up to this fourth, I think he just wins.
Especially with the Zealots taking the first couple of shots from the Lurkers. Because if you
There's
sort
not
of
a good,
absorb
like,
those,
kill zone for the what they're called, clickers. Interesting
pullback. Pull that back really quick, and now Jacko's just like, I'm angry. Takes the base.
I'm gonna click on your stuff.
Yeah. Falls back a little bit. Now, this is the thing. I like that he didn't push too far. He didn't need to go aggressive and try and kill off everything at this base. Just needed to make sure that there was
just
no real mining.
Just taking what he needs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just no real mining is what you need. He also does need to consider his fifth at this point, because his work account is
zealots.
A tiny bit low, 59. It's been interesting. But yeah, these zealot run bys are sweet. I love
at some
this
point
kind of stuff.
This would stop doing damage, right? Like, I mean, these zealots, they just keep going. Now there's lurkers here, so they're never actually gonna do damage. The question is, what kills them quicker, lurkers or the zealots kills the base?
I was gonna say, if you like that many zealots with plus three, if you right click onto the hatchery, you might be able to. I'm pretty sure if you right click on that base, you can actually kill it. But he hasn't.
Yeah.
He's, I think he's 8 clicks.
He's just kind of 8 clicks. He's just living his life. Oh, big fight coming in the natural. I'm pretty sure he wins this too. It's just, he doesn't want to risk it though. The Melbourne land points are on the line, and he's pushing into this fourth. No, wow. Good lineup. The lurkers did a lot of damage.
Yep.
And the bulk amount of the zealots run a line.
It's also interesting to note the upgrades. Just the plus one missile attacks for these lurkers and hydras. So, and then there's very, very few banelings and other melee units mixed in. So
banelings become incredibly inert once the archons and immortals get added into the mix.
Yeah.
But this composition's so strong, you're not prepared to fight this army comp.
Yeah.
Although when I go this army comp, like 20 mutas fly in my base, and I just feel really mad. I'm like, oh, I really can't follow you.
Killing off a few drones there. The lurkers at the top of the ramp will hold back Jacko for the time being. Mortal Archon and a couple of sentries will just fall back for the time being. And I'd love to see another Oracle, just to make sure that we've got good revelations going off all the time.
That way he can keep cycling the tags,
But so now objective for Crimson right now is to consider grabbing a fifth base as soon as he can. It's going to be very difficult because we've got these roving packs of zealots that are constantly going around the map, along with seemingly roving packs of probes right now. Looks if he gets a good tag. Yep. Zealot charging in, taking some of the hits. The Hydras are grouped up. They are going to take a storm to the face. A couple more lurkers do burrow down there, and they will hold the position for now. But, a couple of very cute lurkers here, just over on the right-hand side.
Trying their best.
Yeah.
This Void Ray, dude. Stopped a triple drop, killed some lurkers. That's a hero right there.
Six kills. So that's really nice.
Crucial kills.
That's true. Fleet Beacon
is lurkers.
Done.
Uh-oh. He can just get into his nat and checkmate him. Lurkers have to sit down,
No. Crimson in a lot of trouble. Excellent storm, just to block off everything here. Another great storm, and that is probably going to be it. I don't think there's any way Crimson can get back out of that. So that is a GG. We are now at 2-1 with Crimson just in front of Jacko, fighting back with a different kind of style in game number 3.
That's a hard style to pull off on Cactus Valley. There's a lot of maps where you can get free bases, but that is not one of them.
Yeah, yeah.
What's our current score? 2-1 Crimson?
2-1 Crimson, yeah.
Oh, man. We're going to get the reverse all kill.
Ooh.
I hope.
Could be coming.
Jacko's showing signs, and he looked really good in that game.
Yeah.
Like, he took control of that game early.
That was a really good game, and yeah, good defense in particular, and then slowly pushed it out into being an offensive game. So it was it was good to see that he wasn't too phased about
he
what
didn't
was
overextend.
Going. Yeah.
He didn't overextend either. He took what he needed.
Yeah.
And then there's this map that's awful. I don't like Honor Grounds as a Zerg. I think this is a really hard map. The Protoss gets like, it literally gets 5 bases for free, and there's not much you can do about it.
Yeah, it's a big, and it's cumbersome in the way you move around the map because of the rocks sort of blocking certain pathways and stuff like that.
It's like a dumb whirlwind. Like, look at it.
It is. It's true. Or maybe Cool Ass Ravine.
Yeah, Kulas Ravine.
Oh
that's
my
an old
god,
one.
That's old school. So down in the bottom left, we've got our red Zerg Crimson. Top right is our green Protoss Jacko. And, we'll see what's going on.
Come on, Crimson.
This is going to be Nexus first from our Protoss.
His hatch is going to be a little late, Crimson's. Little bit, like one drone late. He was like, I need to go make this hatch. I need to return the minerals. And then he kind of gish golloped around. I hate to see that.
And then, they're actually
incredibly safe Nexus first.
Basically, same timing, yeah.
I would like Crimson to get a quick third as well. Like, this map is just. The Protoss is going to macro, and there's nothing that you can do about it. You may as well macro.
Yeah. That's right. I think the one thing that I find annoying sometimes on this is the Protoss is just Ling drops early on when you kind of just say, hey, yeah, what's going on? You maybe kill one or two probes or something like that. But it's just kind of annoying because there's a lot of space around this map to get into the main and the nat, because, of course, there's sort of connected, basically a 2v2 style map. And I think that's the problem with it. It's kind of a 2v2 style map.
There's so many
bases. You've got your mate just in the same base with you, and
you're like, all right, dude, who gets the natural? Yep. I do. I'm the better player. I'm in masters. You're in gold. Just let me get the base.
Oh my god!
And then you die because you're macroing.
Yep. And then you're playing Zerg and you like creep up the natural and someone gets mad at you because they can't wall off.
Dude, I can't build my base.
I can't wall off.
I don't want you to wall off. You're gonna trap me in.
Yep. Give me control. No, I don't want you to have control.
No. Dude, I have 480 APM. Let me control your units. That's what I say. Oh, this rogue canceled its swing. What are you doing? Oh, no. Oh, it's going to get him anyway. Oh, man. You hate to see that.
This guy, this drone here. Just have a look at this guy who just refused to finish off the kill. He's not a killer.
He's not a killer. He's a pacifist. Yeah. And you know what? I think most drones are pacifists. Their only goal in life is to die. Well, or do they really die when they turn into a building, or do they just live on in a different form?
They evolve.
They evolve, wow.
Yeah.
So deep.
So deep.
So deep.
So got
okay,
the,
this is not a wall at the top.
No, I was just thinking that.
Oh!
Get a shot!
What?
Oof, gets a shot, but does see the robo, yeah.
Does not see the Twilight, but you can kind of assume if he's getting a robo, he's going to be getting glazed.
Whoa.
Crimson's got a pretty good idea.
Whoa. It could be drop Colossus build, okay?
Dark Shrine.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Blink DTs is happening, guys.
It's time.
Blink DTs is happening.
And this is a good time to do it, too, because Zergs are going to be macroing like crazy. They're like, I'm making drones and nothing else, and you can't stop me. And you're going to stop them. Not on my watch.
Not on my watch.
Not on my watch. I'm not making drones.
Yeah, not on my watch. And so the third base is just about done here for Crimson. So he's... gonna get that macro into gear right now.
Yeah, look at this queen connecting the nat in the main.
Oof, look at that.
I like seeing that.
Whoa. Hang on. This is the third in the main.
Oh, you're right. We need to see the nat in the main.
Nat in the main is over here. There's a bit of a difference, so we'll see what happens there. But
so I'm still disappointed.
Yeah. No, I'm definitely disappointed.
Speed overlords.
Is he?
It's really important. Oh, he goes deep with these speed overlords. You might think all of his tech is right here.
He's just like, you've got... Who thinks he's foregating? You look at that and you're like...
Well, this is normal.
Well,
it's economical to do foregates and expand.
The best thing...
Warp Prism's a little late. Like, he's going to have the Dark Shrine, unless he's going to warp in DTs and then...
Oh, he's just going to go straight through the vision as well of the Lings of the tower.
Yeah, that's not the end of the world. It's pretty normal at this point in the game to have glaives.
It's hard to, like, avoid that, but still. Not researching Blink.
No lair! No lair, no spores!
Oh, dear.
Uh-oh. This is not good.
Uh-oh.
Now, the question is, how does Jacko approach this? Does he target down hatches? Does he target down drones? Does he go for tech? Literally, the world is his oyster right now. He's going to be unfettered no matter what he does.
Crimson must be looking at this one Ling attacking the front door and just thinking,
where's your stuff, dude? Like, that's what I would be thinking. I would be making spores right now, but maybe that's because I can see everything and I'm eternal as a spectator.
That's true.
Get the queen. And now he knows. Oh, they're trapped. He can trap them here. Thor Prison can pick them up. But... it takes 4 Ravager Bile shots to kill a DT, by the way. I learned that in the latter game
I
lost.
There you go.
So he's going to get the hatch. That's okay. I think you're totally happy with that. Just getting the hatch and getting out, and then you have 2 Archons back home. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
And he's going to go right into his army composition of Archon Immortal.
You know what he could have done? If he had Blink, he could blink down to this third base.
He could blink down. Yeah. Oh, he can get this 4. Ooh. Get this 4. Get it. Oh, there's a transfuse. No, he can't get it. It doesn't lose anything though.
Gets out, yeah, yeah, it gets out of there. Really nicely done. There's there weren't
look at the units lost. Yeah. Look at that. One probe.
So there was one worker kill, I believe it was. No, sorry, five worker kills. So gets a couple. Not bad. Plus gets his hatchery. And you know, on the units lost tab we can see that that's a pretty sizable.
And he locks
amount.
Down map control by doing that. And now he's gonna do these Archon drops, and let me tell you, these Archon drops are awful to defend. Like these things like two shot queens, it's rough.
Yeah.
Maybe especially, not as strong as Blink DTs,
yeah.
But
I also like the especially I like the plus one is on the way as well. The plus one for Archons is really good because that gives you that extra little punch.
Is he gonna... I think he needs a break point, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, this is greedy, yeah. Killing speed overlords. I mean, he's going to do it, but you don't feel good about it. And this Nidus is going to come in a blind spot, I think. I think he's going to come right in Jacko's main. And you see he's building cannons because he's not too sure on his defense.
That's true.
Oh, man. This Archon drop. Oh, man. I hate Archons.
For me,
why can't I need a non-biological unit I can build a Zerg and I'll be happy. Even my buildings are biological.
For me as Jacko, oh. I'm sort of looking at this. I'm like, you haven't rebuilt the third, so either it's going to be across on the left or something fishy is going on.
And the Nidus, it's about to pop. This is when you do the logic check as Protoss. You're like, how can I lose this game? Like,
put down a couple of creep commanders. Very nice. I'm not sure about attacking that pylon.
I like attacking this base. He cuts his base off. But he's gotta go quick because the army's reinforcing. Oh, the disruptor shot! Oh.
Ooh.
Not great.
One disruptor, here it goes. Oh. Bang!
That's
gets
right.
One of the ravages, not too bad.
Wait, what is
like...
that spell?
Well,
I haven't seen that. An expansion.
Yeah.
Got another disruptor shot.
It's a disruptor, very nice.
Oh, the Archon drop.
Archon's dropping in, yeah.
Oh, this
that's
is
really
over.
Good. Lots of workers have been killed off, though, so Crimson's done a really good job.
Oh, the disruptor shot! Oh! He killed the stalker!
Kills off a couple of his own units. It looks as if, Crimson is going to be forced to retreat out of this one here, but has he done enough damage? I don't think so.
It's a lot of damage. He definitely didn't do nothing, but I feel like if he walks in, clicks on the Nexus, and then starts fighting the army, he's in a way better spot.
Yep. What we can point out is that he has connected the Protoss main and that to each other with creep.
Oh!
He is about to do it. There we go.
That's true. I guess this game's a success.
Great success.
Also, we may as well call this base that has his lair his natural, because he has no intentions of taking that in-base natural ever again. So he gets a pass on connecting the main and that.
It's like dirty now. He's like, ugh.
Yeah, it's ruined by DTs. There could be a DT there right now.
That's true. There's like
this mothership core is like, what have you done to my base? You monsters.
Who didn't clean up their room? But, whoop!
Oh,
okay.
Well, that's not enough DPS.
Oh, look out.
I like the spunk. Oh, man, the drop's going back. So let's see if he has a third. And he's like, dude, you still don't have a third.
He's gonna have a look in here.
Oh, he stops the
like,
upgrades.
What?
That's efficiency.
Very cool. I really, there was a period of time where people were using Contaminate quite a lot. But then it sort of dropped off again.
I'm a dirty two-base muta player, so I use it all the time.
Right.
If I can stop your medivacs from coming out or your widowmines from coming out, that's a win.
Yep. I'm not really sure why it doesn't get used very often. Like, it's not like people massively and actively
use changelings.
It's
high-risk, low-reward.
I suppose, yeah.
Because you have to have the overlords in position to turn into overseers, and then you have to hope they don't have any actual anti-air, and it's going to tax your multitasking and APM, and if you're a slower player or... you're already having enough problems, you know, conquering the game as it is. It's really going to tax resources you don't have.
That's true.
And this is a huge death ball coming across the field for Jacko.
I was just looking at that and I'm like, that's a lot of stalkers. Keeping in mind,
these
they've got
Biles
Blink.
These need to be good.
Yeah, they've got Blink and plus one. Disruptor Shot comes out. Takes out a couple, not too bad. Ooh.
Well,
often you get to see a vial hit.
Bring your umbrellas. Oh no, that's not the way you want a micro.
Good hit. And I don't think Crimson can hold this. This is way too much.
Really
just stuff.
Good. Wow.
Just stuff. There you go. There's even a warp in up the back. A couple more stalkers coming into the fight. Blink forward.
And
stalker donut.
On top of them.
see you later.
And there it is.
And that is it. It was a really cool game. Great with some game. Really interesting little nuances in how that game worked out. So it is now 2-2. We will go into our first
game of the night. Last the game absolute night. Last game.
Yep.
And then I get to sleep. Us Americans.
Why would you sleep?
It's the perfect time.
That's true.
I really think Crimson is going to take this. He showed some good play, but I think he's figured out this Immortal Archon technique. I think he's really going to take it. I want him to take it. Because I'm a Zerg. What can I say? A little bit of vibe. Especially if he connects his main in that.
I'm not sure. Especially this map.
It's Abyssal. It's favored for Zergs. This because of the weirdness to it. Like, drops are really strong in this map. It's hard to maintain a base.
Yeah, we'll...
I want to see Crimson just cheese him. His cheese has been really good.
The old queen drop busted out again. So top left-hand side, we've got Crimson. And bottom right, of course, we have our Protoss player, Jacko. We'll be building up at... Oh, Forge up here. And a second probe going out. Well, this could be decided quite quickly.
Well, we wanted a cannon rush. What a game to have it in.
Yeah. I was just
thinking. Man. The Lake of Lekafun!
Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Immediately, I'm scouting my whole base. Yeah, I'm like, knows. What?
You have He's to know at that point. You're like, you have to oh, know. Shit. Oh, no.
That's the oldest trick in the book. Oh, it's out of vision range.
Don't go back on the creep. Don't let him see.
No, you fool. What are you doing?
No, don't do that.
Oh, no. Give me some pog champs in chat. Oh, the wall in. There's no rocks here.
Get the building pylon. Oh, no.
Oh, he can't. It has too much health. There's no surface area. He's going to get him down. I don't know about that positioning. That's kind of weird, but yeah. Maybe it's the only place.
Oh. Okay. That's cool.
Oh, it makes sense.
Yeah.
This is getting interesting.
I don't know how I feel about building the, canceling the pylons. It's actually kind of cool sometimes.
I like that. Yeah, I like canceling
it. I'd cancel one. I wouldn't cancel the second one. Just because sometimes having the second one up there for vision and for the potential to block someone from coming down the ramp is actually quite useful.
I don't think this one's going to die. Ooh, yeah, I was going to say, I didn't think this one was going to die. And this other one is in range of the natural, so he's going to have to cancel it if he sees it. Let's see his vision. Yeah, he sees this one. No, he canceled it. Ooh. That was razor thin, and
are we gonna cancel the rough. Gate? No.
No, I would keep the gate. You can build a cyber helm. That's fair enough. Yeah, he's gonna build a cyber. Pretty standard.
He's actually fully walled off the gnat as well. I mean, his own main. So.
Is this fully?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it is. Wow. He's just building stuff in his natural. He's like, you know what? This is my base now. You get nothing. But Crimson doing everything right. He's going to do a Ravager bust, I assume. Ravagers are just so good on one base. There's a reason there's a really good Ravager one base all in.
Yep.
He's even got Larva pooled.
I love the fact that Jack has actually found this one drone that's out on the map. Somehow he found it with a probe. It's like, what?
He's got good star sense. Mm. He's a champion. The question is, he's going to get a Robo. I really would have liked Jacko to get a Stargate here and make a Void Ray. Like, there's nothing he can really do on one base that can beat a Stargate. Like, if he goes Mutas, you go Phoenix. If he goes anything ground-based, you have a Void Ray. And he's going to start cleaning this up. God, he's just building more stuff. Is he going to proxy Immortals?
Oh my God.
What is this?
I don't think he can.
I don't think it's going to get up in time.
Oh, cannons are pretty good.
These are going to be Ravagers and he's supply blocked. Come on, Crimson. He's going to extract your trick. Some Ravagers. There you go. That's what you got to do.
This is all going to depend on this mothership core, which is making its way across the map.
Yeah. This drone is still alive. Living its life. It's looking for rallies, and there just isn't going to be any because there's a Robo here. Mm. That Crimson hasn't seen. He hasn't seen this, and it's right outside the base. He's lazy now. Oh man, what a weird last game. Oh, he's gonna try and break it fully. Mothership core, almost.
He has to hit the pylons as well. This
hit
is really...
the pylon. Oh no, it got overcharged. And the Immortal's almost out. Oh no.
Cannon's really low, which is good, but... Yeah.
But there's only a queen that shoots up. Another? Okay, I was gonna say another one. Oh, good to be the other one.
Immortal is going to help reinforce his position here. Of course, they do bonus damage against armored, which is the roaches here. But we'll see. One overcharge. I was going to say, I probably...
No, the monster should
be careful about pushing this. Oh, that cannon's so low.
So close.
Probably could have got the cannon there.
It's like razor edge for both players.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, he's going to lose his Ravager. That's pretty big. Oh, he saves it. Wow. This queen's like, do I have enough range?
Oh, whoa, whoa. Where are you going, my friend?
Oh, he's just baiting some lings, dude. All part of the plan. All part of the plan. Not even worried.
I think
he got shield.
I think, yeah, I was going to say, I think
he's done
busted it. Yeah, yeah.
Good micro. He's going to kill the cannon if he has to. He's up 20 supply.
Ooh,
good
targeting by Jacko. Yeah, really nice.
But he
nice
has nothing else. Mm. This is everything. I think he's done it. I think Chris has taken it.
I'm
trying to make a desperation. He needs to really unpower this,
yeah,
this robo. Come on. That pylon doesn't do anything.
Come on.
Come on.
You could even consider letting the immortal come out, because you're gonna kill it immediately.
Yeah, I think you canceled it, though. It's smart. Yeah. Man, how do you get back into this? Like, the Ravagers are just going to end the game. He's even got an Overlord here for high ground vision. Wow, what a game.
He's got a robo building back home, so he is going to try
and get
something out.
And he can make a lot more
out.
Ravagers.
Yeah.
God,
I think,
like, dude.
I think
Stargate,
I'm telling you. Yeah, if it was a Stargate, or if this robo back home was a little bit quicker, or if the initial robo was back at home, I think then he would have been...
Like, if he transitioned out of it to macro or something,
exactly,
that'd be nice.
Yeah. Like,
but he wanted to kill him there. He had blood in the water. He had that killer instinct. And we have four more Ravagers on the way. Oh, my gosh.
And the best thing about this game is that the natural and the main is going to be connected by creep. I mean, that's probably the deciding factor, I'd say. Yeah. So
you have 24 probes and one mothership core with 7 roaches, 6 ravagers, and 2 queens.
I think
it's
the main
close.
Difference. Yeah, I think the main difference, as you said, was probably to transition back to macro. But you do want to have those pylons and the cannons there, so that the mothership core can try and control that natural low ground. And I think that'll be it.
Yeah.
Down goes the cyber. That is it.
The
really
immortal.
Cool. I liked the attempt. It was very, very cool.
Of course, we have hindsight 50-50.
Yeah,
we're saying macro,
yeah,
but he may have killed him there, and wow! Jacko taps out. 3-2 Crimson denies the reverse all kill. What an awesome series.
Yeah, that was really cool. That was a great set of games to watch.
That was a treat.
Yeah.
That was a treat.
I think, I wasn't sure. At first, because I was like, ooh, Jacko's been doing really good with his, with his macro sort of style later on and sort of boosting up those units that he needs
he
to get.
He found the unkillable unit composition and he just kind of cheesed them.
Yeah, then it was like, oh, bugger it. We'll just get the old cheese out. So it will be Crimson moving forward. So that means that the semi-finals here at the Probe StarCraft League will feature Seether versus Demilove and Aigus versus Crimson. So that'll be a TVZ and a TVZ on both sides
of
the bracket.
My favorite matchup, personally.